the home of the A's since 1968, it's baseball at the Oakland Coliseum. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the New York Mets and the Chicago Cubs. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. So now here is Jonathan Villar. He will lead this one off today. A ball and two strikes now. Shaping up to be a pretty nice day for baseball. 69 degrees here at first pitch. Hot shot toward third. Leaps high as he makes the catch. Well done. Next to hit, Brandon Nimmo. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Looped out toward third. And that's the second out. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. 2-1.
Count is 2-1.
Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. He can't get there, so the inning will continue.
Batting four. The first baseman.
Into the box now. Pete Alonso. Hit out toward second. And that's through for a hit.
That is it. The right fielder.
Standing in now, Michael Conforto. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. And the threat won't pay off. The inning is over. Striding in is number 66. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
I got 3-1.
Number 18 will be next. And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory. And this will wind up a foul ball. 3-2 pitch. Smoked on the ground left side. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Batting second, the first baseman, number 18.
So now to the plate, number 18. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And this will wind up working as a sacrifice as he steps on first, allowing the runner to move into second. Next up, Ian Happ.
The left fielder, Ian Happ.
One is taken for ball two. Swing and a little tapper. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Two out, runner in scoring position at second. And stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras. Ready with the 1-1. And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Second inning set to go, and with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. Two and two. The 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Jeff McNeil will be the next to take a turn. No score here as we play inning number two. in front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw on to first, two gone. Next up is James McCann. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's got a 3-for-7 line. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Count is 2-1.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
And that misses ball four, and now the Mets have themselves a two-out base runner. So here's the Mets pitcher, Marcus Stroman. Ready with the 1-1. Bounce to first. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Last half of the second set to go, and set to go is the third baseman, Patrick Wisdom. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
Batting quick.
So here is Matt Duffy. Wisdom aboard here at first with nobody out. It's 1-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Nimmo in pursuit, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. In now is Nico Horner. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone.
He's gone.
Runners off for second. Grounded back up the middle. Scooped up. Throw gets him. Two down. So now into the box is number 43. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Stays alive here as he gets a piece of this, and in turn he gets a piece of the catcher behind the plate. To two balls and two strikes now.
When a pitch is close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes. And that will retire the side. Now back to the top of the Mets order, digging in, Jonathan Villar. He'll start things out against Kyle Hendricks as we get the inning underway. Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Sinker, 3-2 now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can look.
Drives it to deep right field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. So here's Brandon Nimmo. Third inning, no score to this point. Grounded down the third baseline. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time at first for out number two. Bases are empty here with two away. And with it comes Francisco Lindor to the plate. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. swing and a ground ball to third. That gets through and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game. The tag, and they'll get him at second, and with that the side is retired. At the plate, Kyle Hendricks. This is flared out towards second. Throws in time, and that's out number one. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, number 66. Second at bat here. He reached via a single to lead off the home first.
Hey, going back to his first at bat, that was a terrific at bat. Saw a lot of pitches, and one of the things you want to do is try to drive that pitch count up early on the starting pitcher.
Now at the plate, here is number 18. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Fly ball into straightaway left. And McNeil will put it away to retire the side. One for one with a single so far.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs. This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. Digging in next, Michael Conforto. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Number 43 is there, and he has it for the out. Base is empty, two away, and into bat next, the versatile weapon Javier Baez. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. Now a move over to first, and he's back in standing. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy.
And the third baseman makes the play. That ends the inning. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. Now the 2-1 pitch. Will not catch the zone, ball three.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. And he struck him out. So he's down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. So one away here in the Chicago fourth. And Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Oh, and he struck him out as well. So he's carving right through the heart of this lineup as there are two away now.
Number 16.
Now at the plate is Patrick Wisdom. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. And he lays off it to even the count, 2-2. High in the air and deep to left center field. Center fielder going back to the track, to the wall. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Into the box, Matt Duffy. Hit out towards second. And a sliding attempt at second, but he can't corral it, and that ought to be a base hit.
The batter, the shortstop, Nico Horner.
Stepping in now, Nico Horner.
At the ball.
Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. And it's fouled away. The 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Now another 2-2. Hit on the ground out to short. They'll go to Baez at second for the force, and that ends the inning. James McCann worked a walk in his first plate appearance.
Hey.
1-1 pitch is a sinker taken for his strike 1-2.
One ball, two strikes, count.
Swing and a liner, but this will land in foul territory. Still 1-2. High in the air down the right field line. And no one will track it down. He'll try again, 1-2. Ripped on the ground to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next to dig in, Marcus Stroman comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Mets pitcher behind at the plate with a ball and two strikes. Swinging a blooper to the right side. Duffy moving to his left, and he makes the catch for the second out. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Jonathan Villar, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Hit hard down the line. A dive, and he knocks it down. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single. In now, Brandon Nimmo. And he's keeping it down here, and that's a called strike two. Nimmo with an even count of 2-2 now. Now a throw over, runner's back. This is hit the other way out toward left field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Ready now is number 43. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Nope,
and this is low, ball two. 2-1. Oh, now here's a drive out to the alley. Around first, digging for two. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Now back, the pitcher, Kyle Hendricks.
To the plate now, Kyle Hendricks. And he pops up the bunt attempt. There to take it is VR, and that's the first down. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, number 66. A hit in two tries so far. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Got him to reach for it there as this is grounded to short. He's got it, and there are two away now. Up next, number 18, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. A bounce bouncer up the middle. Throw in time and the side is retired. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Number 66 is there and he makes the catch for the out. One away now for the Mets in the sixth, and up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. A ball and two strikes.
Count is one and two.
Hit back up the middle. On to first, and there were two down. And now, Michael Conforto. He flew out in his last AB. A 1-1 home. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Scooped up. And he'll make that play look easy as the throw is in time to end the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. The 1-1 home takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
One and two.
To two balls and two strikes now. Here now the 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So here's the cleanup hitter, Wilson Contreras. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Throw on to first, two gone. So next to hit is Patrick Wisdom, who went deep last time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
One and two now as that one's fouled off.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep?
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Bias already the beginning of the seventh inning here, as this game has had a very brisk pace to it so far. A swing and a ball into the corner that hooks foul. Ready on one and two.
I got to count two and two.
Now a foul tip right into the catcher's glove as he's able to hang on for the first down. So here's Jeff McNeil. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And it's belted high and deep into right center. A ball that's carrying, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And there's your tying run at second base with a one-out double. And Blake now, James McCann. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Luis Guillorme will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. No runs, five hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's one and two now. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Over to first, and that retires the side. Seth Lugo will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 67.
Bottom of the inning now, and set to go is the second baseman, Matt Duffy. The 3-1. swing and a little blooper to center. Coming in is Nimmo, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
The batter, two. Shortstop, Nico.
Standing in now, Nico Horner. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
There's one on to first, and they get them both. So next to bat will be number 43. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
It's funny. That pitch, I can picture being in the box. That pitch looks so good to hit. Why does no one ever get to it? A good executed high fastball usually blows 9 out of 10 guys away.
He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Adam Morgan will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Sergio Alcantara is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Bounce it to the left side, right to him. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. So now to the plate, Brandon Nimmo. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Whoa, that's down.
Breaking ball called just a bit low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are 2 gone. So here's Francisco Lindor now. The 1-1. Fouled away. Gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Duffy is there, and the side is retired. Digging in, the switch hitter, Sergio Alcantara. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the 8th after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. He ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
The 2-2. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Now to the plate. Here is number 66. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. The 1-1. And he misses 2-1. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. And there's out number two. The next hub up, number 18. He grounded out last time up. Hits are even right now at five aside. Outside, two and one.
Hey, this is a huge at bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
This is line to left, into the slide, and he comes up with a great catch to end the inning. Rowan Wick comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 50.
Now at the plate, Pete Alonso. His career numbers in this matchup, he's 1-for-2. Up high, 2-1 now.
Down by a run, your guy needs to get on any way he can. His mentality has to be to shrink this strike zone to like the size of a soup can. No reason to swing at a pitcher's pitch.
Fouled off. Now the 3-2 pitch. Count remains full. The next 3-2. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Center fielder giving chase. And he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. Stepping up is Michael Conforto. He bounced out last time up. One run game here in the top of the ninth. And it's fouled away.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Number 66 is there, and he'll bring this one in. Mets down to their final out now. With it comes Javi Baez to the plate. The 2-1 is laid off up for ball number three.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit when the count's in his favor like this.
He's able to ride this one high and deep toward right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And hold all tickets now as the tying run gets into scoring position with a two-out double.
Number 6.
Into the box, Jeff McNeil. Little dribbler up the third baseline. One and two, here it is. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. And now this crowd, estimated at around 26,000 fans, comes to their feet. Now a swing, and he pops him up. And this should do it. Alcantara is there. Makes the catch, and the ball game is over.
Wow, that's a rarity. A 1-0 game in baseball these days. Both of these pitchers pitched awfully well. It's a shame one of them had to lose this game.
A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 the final score. The Chicago Cubs took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Kyle Hendricks takes home the win. Marcus Stroman to settle with a loss after giving up only one earned. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. One run, five hits, no errors. They left four men on base. For the Mets, no runs, six hits, no errors. They left seven men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 20 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.